Record types are still a mystery to many C# programmers. Records are much more than just DTOs or a shorthand notation for a class. They are a functional modeling tool. Let me show you an example of redesigning a common class. I will be modeling a video in this demo that will cause several issues, which I will then solve with generous use of records. There is always some data in the class. I am omitting state validation for brevity. Then come the operations. This one applies lazy loading of the video's binaries. It is a useful method. Classes shine in requests like this. But then come troubles. The next operation clips the video to make a shorter one. I am adding state and a lot of arithmetic juggling around it. This code is correct. There is no bug in it. But you will quickly realize how dangerous this method is when I start using it. Start with an object representing a 5-minute-long video. Clip its first minute out to retain a portion of the original video. Then clip it once again into an even shorter video clip. Clipping is cumulative, and I have implemented it in a mutable class. The stage is set to break it. The request is to make as many clips as possible, starting at every 40 seconds and lasting 10 seconds each. How hard can it be? Just cut it out and display the details of the resulting video. The problem is that this loop will not work. Understanding the root cause of this problem will help you accept records, so you better stay focused now. I expect to see a handful of clips when I run the application. Let me see the output. Just as I expected, wrong. There is only one 10-second clip and nothing else. The trouble is with mutation. When I clipped the long video, it became a short one. The next time the loop evaluates its condition, it is false and the loop terminates. I've got myself a bug of the size of a house. I might ask the video to undo the previous mutation on itself. Don't judge me. What else can I do in a mutable class? Here is the final design of the video class. It shows everything I don't like about object-oriented design. It is bloated with state, which I didn't manage quite well. It defines loosely related methods, including the one which is nothing but a workaround for the issue caused by the mutation. Sooner or later, I will have to redesign this class into a few smaller ones. That might not happen today, but it will surely come. Enter records. The demo you came for begins now. I will redesign everything into the form of types, not classes. A record is a class, of course, unless declared as a record struct. But we view them differently from classes. Take the video type as an example. I want you to detach from that class mentality now. A type consists of other types all until primitive types are hit. What was the video about? It was about the title, the binary content, and the duration. Well, I think I already made a design mistake. Records make you think in small units. I think the video is not title, content, and duration. I think it is the title and the binary media. The media is an entirely different type that knows its binary content and duration. Do you feel the change in the air? This might be your first step into functional design. Welcome. In functional design, we define types that consist of other types. The behavior will only come later in the form of extension methods. Many people ask me about the validation of records, so let's clarify that now. It is hard to understand record validation if your mind is stuck with the design of classes. It is typical to accompany a record with static factory methods that sanitize input and produce a valid instance on the output. Some programmers object that the record still exposes a public constructor that evades any validation. Yes, but you don't call it. You use factory methods instead. Functional programming is as much about disciplined coding as it is about knowing the principles. Then comes the behavior in the form of extension methods. It is usual practice to create one extension's class per feature. This class will manage the loading of the video media. You can download the entire source code from my Patreon page. Keep in mind that every registered patron helps hundreds of other fellow programmers watch content on my channel for free. So visit me on Patreon, become a sponsor, and download the source code for all the videos on my channel. Now I want to develop that same populate method as before, only this time attached to the video media type as an extension. It differs from the method we defined on the class in two ways. First, it is an extension. Second, it is immutable. The class method used to mutate the current object. It returned a void, or since it was asynchronous, a task with no result. The functional method must always return a new object that reflects the change. Hence, this method produces a new video media instance asynchronously. Methods in functional design are either immutable, like this one, or produce a side effect, but not both. Then comes another significant trait of immutable methods in functional programming: pattern matching. If you have survived it so far, you will quickly adopt the habit of matching inputs against patterns rather than using imperative constructs. When the object's content is empty, we use the with expression to produce a new instance. This is that non-destructive mutation of records. The input record remains unchanged. Otherwise, we avoid the repeated cost of I/O. This completes one entire feature attached to the video media type. Move the feature and the record into their own files. And there you go. A clean and simple video definition using a record. You may think I've got nothing useful yet, but that would be a gross understatement. Let me give you a quick demo of what this nice record can do for me. I wish to load videos from files. Will that be hard with such an empty record? Not at all. This async lambda will load the file's content. Use it to obtain the modified content. That was easy. Now simply create the new video object using the with expression. This is how the creators of C# have envisioned the use of records. Define their data components. Then define extensions with the behavior you need. Move this code to its own file and you've just added another feature to the model. By this point, you have already learned all the fundamental design rules that apply to C# records. Keep them immutable. Keep them small. Compose them into larger types. Only create them through factory methods. Attach behavior via extension methods. Define one feature per extension class. I will now make you a master of designing and consuming records. This is the new record type modeling a clipped video. The clip contains a time interval, so here is the record defining it. Observe how detailed the validation is in this factory method. Can you imagine working with naked time spans and having to do these arithmetic checks all over the code base? I wouldn't trade this record for anything in the world. That finally brings us to the central requirement, clipping. It would be another pattern matching expression, which matches the interval against a few possible patterns. Unfortunately, the new switch expression syntax does not support expressions of this sort. Therefore, I used chained ternary operators, one Boolean condition per pattern. Are you ready to see this functional model in action? The moment of truth. It all starts with lazy loaded media for a 5-minute long video. We want that media in a video object along with its title. Now we want to create many clips out of this video. According to the request, we need time intervals starting at 0, each having that duration of 10 seconds and distributed with the step of 40 seconds. This interval's generating function is a hidden gem. It produces a sequence of time intervals, ensuring there will be no overflows. This method does all the checks, so you don't have to. Back to where we were, I'm only interested in intervals that start inside the video. And then the magic unfolds. You cannot do this with a common mutable object-oriented model. Apply each clipping interval to the video object. The request was to display these video clips. I will collect them into a list and then apply the console write line method to each. The only reason you might have to collect the items into a list is because link doesn't define the for each extension method. Well, I have defined such an extension method myself, so I don't need this extra list in the middle. Just in case you need help following through this chain of calls, let me point out the types of intermediate sequences. We are starting with the sequence of time intervals, a very long one. We drop most of them, so we now retain a much shorter sequence. We finally apply an immutable transform to obtain a sequence of video clips before applying an action to each. Of course, the action produces no result, so this entire chain of calls is just an action. Now compare the complexity of the for loop above with what I have got here and judge for yourself. There is this call to reset clipping as a grim reminder of the pitfalls of mutable design. Let me run the application one more time so you can see that both variants produce the same output. There are a handful of clips displayed, each starting and ending as requested. The difference is only in implementation. I believe you're on my side now, trusting that record types were added to C# as a functional modeling tool. Use them that way and you will love them. Stay on my channel now and watch other videos that will improve your programming skills.